So I came up to Quebec in March. I had a vacation. I had 2 weeks off. And I always try to do different things. I have my kids with me, and I took them to Europe the year before. I try to do stuff to educate them and make it interesting for them, something they can remember. So this year, my son said, "Hey, Dad," he was watching something on Nickelodeon. He goes, "You ever been dog sledding?" I said, "No." "Shit, come to think of it, no." He goes, "Can we go dog sledding?" I said, "We can do whatever the fuck we want, can't we?" So I made a couple of phone calls. We drove up here to Quebec, and I charted this dog sledding trip. Now, anybody ever dog sledded in here before? Yeah, a few people, okay. For those of you who haven't, let me take you through the process. I love dogs. I have 4 dogs. My kids love dogs. I'm a dog lover, and I just thought it was going to be the greatest thing in the world. It's a little bit frightening when you get to the dog sledding place, because it's out in the countryside, first of all, and it's like a 3 or 4 hour trip. And it's 3 days in a row. So you're going to be dog sledding, for quite a long time. But I was into it. We had cameras ready. It was going to be like our big outdoorsman hunting type of experience. 4 sleds. And the kids are not going to not drive their own sled. They're going to be in the sled with, in front of me. I'm going to drive a sled. And you get in there, and they give you this big safety speech. And it's like an hour. And it kind of scares the living daylights out of you. Because you see the dogs being taken out, Siberian Huskies, one by one, and put on the sleds. And there's like 10 dogs per sled. So as the guy's giving you the safety speech, there's all these dogs being pulled out of little cages, going, "Arr, arr, arr," with blue eyes. "Arr, arr, arr," and they put them on the sled. "Arr, arr," and they got all these ice picks they're sticking in the ground to make sure the sled doesn't move. And guys holding the dogs back, and you're like, "Holy fucking shit. What did I get my kids into? My God." And over the din of the dogs, this French guy is going, "No, you must pay attention to this because this is very important." And I'm like, what? And he's explaining, "You have to steer this sled with your this, and when the dog does this," and I'm like, "Fuck, I gotta really drive this thing. I thought the dogs would just take the whole thing." "Very important to remember the name of your head dog." And I'm like, "The head dog?" So there's 3 sleds. First guy gets Rocky, that's his head dog. Second guy gets Lobo, that's his head dog. I get Renee. Fucking Renee. And for 3 days, you gotta be, "Renee! Renee to the left, Renee to the right." I get the one fag dog. And Renee was like, he was a good dog, but he was just looking back over his shoulder the whole time, like, "Fuck, man, you're such an asshole." So they take you through this safety thing, man. And I tell you what, besides playing ice hockey, like really playing ice hockey, when you're having, like, in the middle of the game, you can't think about anything else, you really gotta have your eyes open, everything's happening around you, for an hour and a half, you're just in that experience. Dog sledding, when that fucking sled took off, man, it's just, wow. You have never, you're like right in the moment, dodging fucking tree branches and trying to get the thing, and Renee! The first 5 minutes, man, I was like, "This is the greatest fucking experience." I got a big smile, ducking branches, I'm looking at the kids, they're like, "Wow, Dad," I'm like, "Yeah." And then the dogs started to shit. They never explained in the safety training that 10 dogs will shit and fart and piss for the entire trip. Because some of them are scared, some of them have diarrhea, some of them are just trying to piss you off. It was 3 hours of dodging shit and going, "Oh my God." It was a shitstorm. I paid for 3 days to have a shitstorm. A dog shitstorm. The kids are like, "Dad!" I'm like, "Oh! Nothing I can do. Fucking suck it up." "Renee!" "Yeah, great." "Fuck you, Renee." And I have pictures. The kids had the video camera on. It's actually one great shot. It's just literally just like, and we paid for this, kids. Your dad paid for this.